Hi everyone, it's Tawny. I just applied a new lip product because my lip product had like worn off throughout the day. It is currently, let's see, 9 o'clock p.m. and I've been out in the sun all day. I was shopping this evening. I was in the heat. I was in the air conditioning. I'm in the air conditioning now and I'm finally cooling off. It was a long day and I'm wearing a full face of makeup, full coverage makeup, so. Which that's how I like it. So, yeah. I'm wearing the Wet n Wild Cloud Pout in Girl You're Whipped. I'm liking the shade. It smells fabulous. But again, like I mentioned in a previous video, I don't know how I feel about the formula. It's just a little like, I want more. But I feel like this was the intention. So I feel like I should have that in mind. But for me, it's just not quite, like it'd be a good filming lip product. But not so much like constant, like all day kind of a thing. I don't really know. But in today's video, I wanted to talk about mascara. I've been trying to film this video for like months now. Jessica Braun filmed it like not long after I decided to film it. And I was like, she's on the ball and I'm not. And here I am, like, it's gonna seem like I'm stealing her video idea. And I think we kind of both had the same idea. And I kind of think I might have got inspiration from her from a previous video, but that's beside the point. But I wanted to talk about some drugstore mascaras that I don't like. I was hoping to like all of these. I was hoping to like some of these. The more that I got, the more I was hoping they would be better. And I do have to say, as I bought them, they did get better, but not by much. The best one here is not even that great. I wanted to have images of my eyelashes, but I took pictures and I don't know which ones are which. I believe I've used some of these in some videos, so I don't know. I need to try and like do this again and like really try and wear them, but I can just talk about my experience because I definitely have some opinions on all of these. So we're gonna get right into it. The worst mascara of the five that I have, and I'm not going to show them all to you all at once, but I'm just going to kind of go in order and then you'll see them. Some of them were bad because they smudged or smeared, or they were chunky on the eyes and they kind of like clumped together. Some of them just didn't perform the way I wanted. There was no length. There was no lift. Like everything you could think of wrong with the mascara, at least one of these had one of those faults to it. The first one that I think would be the worst one just because of the wear is the Profusion Lash Out Loud Length Volume Lift Mascara. It looks like this. Very cute packaging. I bought this at Walmart. I'm not sure. It was between $5 and $10. I'm going to show you what it looks like when you pull it out of the tube. Okay, so I want you to see this. Look how goopy that is. Okay, I wasn't going to rank this as the worst one, but because of how like crazy goopy this is, I feel like it needs to be. So if you can even see the wand, it has that hourglass shaped wand where it's chunky, thin, and then chunky again, which those are my favorite. So I really like those, and I think those perform the best for my eyelashes because they lift and volumize. And while I don't need much lift, I do like having that lift, and I like the volume. I like my eyelashes to look like spider, like a lot of spider legs, not like a couple of them. I'm wearing the Essence Lash Princess mascara in the green tube today, and this is what I want a mascara to perform like, and none of these did that. This product is so chunky, and like the mascara is so like gooped on here that it was very hard to transfer onto the eyelashes, and it was very hard to get it. Like what would stay very chunky, and you could like see the like chunks of mascara all over the lashes. I really didn't like the way it performed like that. It wore throughout the day, but that wasn't a good thing. I really can't even recommend this if you have a couple dollars and you need to buy one. I honestly cannot even like, I just say if you buy this, throw it away, honestly. Like that's the only thing, like I don't even wanna, like I don't usually sell mascaras because they're eye products, and I just think that like certain eye products I don't want other people to use because I'm afraid that like something could happen. Whereas an eyeshadow palette, you can kind of clean a little bit and like sanitize. But I wouldn't even sell this if I could sell this because it's that bad. Like I will throw this away because I hated it so much. The next one that I didn't like, has a different reason for not liking it, and it is the Revlon So Fierce Big Bad Lash. This is the waterproof version, which I didn't realize I had. The Lash Out Loud was in black, and then this one is in blackest black. I feel like I should mention, I always buy the deepest shade if I can, because that's like, I prefer like a black mascara. I don't do brown, don't do colored. I'm just not really into that. I don't even like, if there's a super black and a black, I feel like that black is not strong enough and doesn't perform like I want it to, like the super black would. So that's what I buy that. That's why I buy that. This one is a very small tube compared to the Lash Out Loud. It is, well, I'll push it down so you can actually see the full height. So it is definitely smaller, which wasn't a big deal, but it definitely looks like a mini. Like when you look at this wand, it performs like a mini. It is again one of those hourglass shapes. It comes out well. It has a little bit of residue on the top, but if you brush that off, you don't have any issues. I find that the bristles are very finely like spaced out really well. It's not clumpy like the Profusion was, but this one never did anything to my lashes. Like, I worked so hard to get it to even show up, and it was mediocre at best, but it just never did anything. And like, I was expecting like big, bold lashes, and I've used Revlon mascaras before that were like the So Fierce kind of like attitude, and they worked better than this. Again, none of them were really great. I have to say that Revlon's not really good with mascara. They had some before that were in like colored tubes that like, they had like different names for different colors essentially. And those were all right. Those weren't like great. They weren't essence level mascaras, but they were definitely like the best for Revlon. This is not, every time I see an ad for this, I just think like, this is a load of crap. Like, I don't believe this. Like, this didn't perform for me. My eyelashes didn't look great. Like, you couldn't really tell I even had like mascara on my lashes. It just looked very like pathetic, and I just was not impressed. And I'm a person that if a mascara doesn't wear well the first time I use it, I don't want to use it again. Like, I don't really want to put forth the effort, because I have ones that work so well that I don't want to waste my time using one that doesn't work. Another one that performed pretty much the same way is the Wet n Wild Big Papa mascara. This is in the shade Blackest Black, and I really like the packaging on this one. This is probably my favorite packaging of the top of these three, and then there's another one that I liked as well. This is what the wand looks like when it comes out. It has that goop at the bottom, but when you wipe it off, it kind of goes in there. This is a little bit wetter of a formula than the Revlon one, but definitely not as clumpy as the Profusion one. But I do think this one is clumpier than Revlon. You can kind of see the bristles are a little bit like overwhelmed with product. This one again performed like Revlon. It was okay, but not great. I didn't really see like the oomph. Like, if you see the commercials and the ads for this, if you watch Wet n Wild's Instagram, they have a lot of people applying this and raving about how good it is. And I just didn't feel like it like lived up to that. It wasn't like a king or a queen mascara. It doesn't like live up to like the Big Papa name. Like, I felt like it was just okay. This is one that like, if you just need a mascara, you don't care what it does, you don't care if it like can do anything special, this one would be okay to get. But honestly, I don't even want you to like waste your money paying $5-6 for this, because it just didn't work how I wanted it to, and it just didn't really do anything. Like why buy a mascara that does nothing? Sometimes mascaras can just like coat your lashes with color, and some people might like that, but for the most part, people want mascaras that do something, and that did not do anything. The next one is the CoverGirl Lash Blast Clean Mascara, and this is in the shade Pitch Black. This is what it looks like. Very cute packaging. I really like the teal, but this is not my favorite of the packaging, I do have to say. It's the next one, but this one is very nice. I really like how sleek it looks. It just looks very like posh and nice, not overwhelming, not in your face, not anything like harsh in any way. It's just very soft. This one has a more cone shaped, it kind of goes to a point. It's a little like squared off point, which it's not like the other three. This is the only one that acts differently. The bristles are those plasticky bristles that are very thin and pokey, and I found that that was an issue with this mascara. I found that I had to be really careful when I did my lower lashes, because I was afraid I'd poke my eye and it would really hurt compared to the other lashes. This mascara stinks. I can smell it like wafting off the wand. I don't like the smell of this. It's very chemical. If you don't like scents with mascaras, you're not gonna like this one or the next one I have to talk about, for so like obviously different reasons, but they're both very scented and fragranced, and it's not pleasant. between what they are. I can't really reveal it until we get there. But this one was okay. But again, it just didn't do anything. CoverGirl has better mascaras. So I would say, I believe it's either the orange one or the green one. I think it's the green one. It's better than this. So this was okay, but not great. I really wanted to like it because it was in the clean line. And I felt like it was just better for you, better for the environment, just kind of had better ingredients. And I believe CoverGirl is Hopping Bunny certified or Leaping Bunny certified, but I'm not positive about that. But I wanted this to be more than what it was, and it was just okay. It was better than the other three, but it wasn't phenomenal. Like, CoverGirl's done better, and that's kind of what I was reviewing it, like, viewing it as. The last one is another one that it's okay, but could be better. It's the Physicians Formula Butter Blowout Mascara. Now, you see what I mean about the scent? This has that coconut scent, and I hate that. Okay, here's what it looks like when you pull it out of the tube. It has a lot of droopiness, which that's gross. I always wipe that off. This, again, is very clumped up. It's not as clean as Revlon's, but it's cleaner than Wet n Wild and Profusion. It coats very nicely. I feel like it does well on the eyes, and if you were to keep applying, like, 3 to 4, like, passes and, like, leave it a little bit, then come back to it, you know what I mean? Like 3 or 4 times, this might work okay. It was okay. It reminds me of the Milani Highly Rated Mascara. That one, again, was okay. It didn't do a whole lot for your lashes, but it was kind of there. This was one I was okay using compared to the others. I was okay using it, okay getting through it. It wore okay throughout the day. It wasn't my favorite one, but this was one I could see myself keeping. And on days where I just, like, don't really want my mascara to look super great or, like, super, you know, wild, or if I just want to do, like, a very casual, everything about me be casual, this might be good. This one, I would say, if you want to support Physicians Formula, go for it. If you can only buy Physicians Formula, go for it. I will definitely say that this one is worth buying. Of all of these, this one is probably the best one you could get, obviously, ranking them all. I definitely think there are way better. I know the Green Leaf mascara from Physicians Formula is a lot better than this. I know it was Tati's favorite a couple years ago, but I think this one's okay. I feel like they're on the right track. They just need a little bit of a momentum. And I also meant, I don't know if I mentioned this, this one is also a cone shape. It looks like it could be a hourglass shape, but it's not, where it kind of, like, flattens out at the end. But I felt like it still performed as if it were an hourglass shape. Like, it still did that lift and the curl, like the volumizing and the curl. So it still performed like how I would want it to. It was just, like, you know what I mean? Like, it just wasn't as powerful as I wanted it to be. It didn't have that blowout effect that it says. So, let me know your thoughts if you tried these before. If you have any of, like, if you've tried these and you actually like these, or if you try these and you hate them. Yeah, thank you guys for watching this video. It was a quick one, but I definitely wanted to get my thoughts out there and share this with you guys before I forgot. Can never forget some of these, honestly. I look at them and I just get angry every time. Like, I swear, they've been sitting on my desk and I'm like, oh, these worked so bad. Oh, and the Physicians Formula was in black. I wanted to mention that, but I don't think it comes in a different shade. But I just wanted to mention that because I was mentioning it for them all. But yeah, thank you so much for watching. Please like, share, and subscribe. Ring that notification bell down below so you get notified on when I upload my videos. And I will see you in the next one. Bye.